Hello and welcome to another update video about Mana. Mana is, in my view, still in a downtrend. Yeah, the last few buy orders that were triggered, and you can find them on Discord if you want to join as a channel member. Then these were triggered at 295, so nearly perfectly at the low here, and the other one was triggered at 330 in this move down here. Before we had this consolidation, we then moved up above. Basically, the price went above both of these buy orders. And then that they could have been sold at a profit here, especially the one that was triggered at 295. But the idea of these buy orders is to wait until we really turn around here in an uptrend and then sell at the sell order prices. But nevertheless, they can also be sold with short-term profit. And then when we move down again, these buy orders could be triggered again. But we are still in a downtrend, you know, even though the downtrend seems to be slowing down, we're still making lower lows here compared to the previous ones. We then moved up again, but again a lower high. Similar, you can see it everywhere. You can see it on the Ethereum chart, again the Solana chart. At the moment, we're just making lower highs, really, even though we make temporarily a new high here on a smaller scale. Zooming out, you can see that we're still making lower highs. And also, if you draw that trend line here to the downside, with 1, 2, and 3 touch points, we are still, I think we tried to break above it, but we are still below it. And if we can't get above it, which would also be above the 320 level, then we're going to sink further, going down to 285 in the next move, which is why I say, you know, if you haven't sold as a channel member, haven't sold your 295 position, if you've been following me, then it might be possible to set that 295 again, because we might drop again to that level down there. Possibly even as far as the 0.887 FIP level at 285. That's a significant low. If you drop below that, that will unlock much lower prices, including the next low, which will be a next key low as well, at 245. That is really a significant low. I think the price will not easily drop below that. And if we drop below that, there isn't much support. There will be here the low that we had back here in November, earlier in November at 220. But then there isn't much that can give us support other than here, the 144-day EMA, but that is as well at the moment at 220, so at that previous low. Below then, we've got the 170 level. I think that will be support. Yeah, we had a previous resistance here. So at the moment, though, we are getting bound here by the FIPS and the EMAs. So we haven't broken above the ascending trend line. I think we are coming down to 285 in the next move, because we cannot break above 320 at the moment. If we do break above 320, I've got a few resistances here. First of all, 343, previous high, then 370, previous high, and then 378, the 0.618 FIP level, before we then climb up the FIP ladder again. But yes, we are moving down. We might see here something like a descending wedge, but it's not very clear. But overall, yeah, you could interpret a descending wedge in here, which then would be a rather bullish pattern, however. But also that would indicate that we probably drop once more to 285 before we then could break out to the upside here. I think we need to come down once more. That's how it looks, because we had a turnaround here on the 4 hour as well. You can see that the MACD did turn around here to the downside, and we're probably just getting a bearish cross here, even though it has just slowed down the downtrend. But we're very close to the crossover here. So at the moment, key decision point, as it seems, do we drop lower from here to 285, or are we actually holding at this level and attempt to break out to the upside? Well, the breakout level here from that level, I said, was 320. If we can't break that, I think 285 for me would make sense to set another buy order here at 295, 296, a little bit higher than 295. But yeah, possibly here at 296, set the buy order again if you're interested in Mana. But that is no financial advice, that's what I'm doing. And then, you know, it can be sold at a next pump up, but that's the key support down here. So, you know, that this is what you can do. Overall, we are here still, as I said, in the downtrend, and because we came up so much, we were then overbought. Did tell you at the time that it's important to think about profit taking, because we were just overbought on the daily, and also on the weekly, massively overbought. And I think we have come out of that now, but what we are seeing here, I think further price drops can be expected because we need to come down a little bit further with the weekly MACD, I think, and on the MACD here, so on the weekly RSI and the weekly MACD hasn't even had a bearish crossover. If you see a bearish crossover there, then you will have a massive, massive drop. I mean, that could take us down to 150 maybe here on the MANA chart. That would be quite a lot. So we need to closely observe that. All right, so hopefully you liked the update video about MANA. If you did, please smash the like button and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye-bye.